I love mowing my lawn. I get so inspired when I'm out here. Just me, my mower, God's green grass. Gives me lots of time to think. So let's just dive right on into it. I live in Tennessee, so if I go to Titan Stadium every weekend, does that make me a Titan? Am I now a pro football player because I go to every game they have? If your answer to that is no, then how come simply going to church makes you a Christian? I'm sure somebody's going to follow up with, well, because I believe. That's all well and good, but believing doesn't make you a Christian. I believe in Satan. I believe he is who he says he is. Does that make me a Satanist? Nope. Same concept here. If you want to be a football player, you need to know how to play football. You can't just say you're a football player. See, but that's where Satan has blurred the lines. He's done a really good job of fooling people into believing that just because they say they're something, they are. Just because I say I'm a rainbow butterfly doesn't make me one. If you're a boy and you say you're a girl, doesn't matter. Doesn't change the facts. You're a boy or you're a girl. There's no in between. There's no 89 genders. You are what you are, whether you say you're that or not. And just because you say you're a Christian doesn't mean you are one. I want to ask you a sincere question, and I don't want you to go Rambo in my comment section. I want you to think about this. I want you to pray about it, and I want you to answer it truthfully. What is the point of repentance if it doesn't come with change? Seriously, why does repentance even matter if you don't have to change your life any? If you want to be a football player, you got to play by the rules. Same thing. If you want to be a Christian, you got to play by God's rules. You got to change your life accordingly. And Christians may have changed some from when they were not Christians, but that doesn't mean you're living a life pleasing to God. It doesn't mean you're doing what God wants you to be doing. God gave us his standards for living, what it means to be a Christian, in the Torah. And Jesus walked those out perfectly and taught them. And all his apostles taught them, including Paul. And anytime I met with resistance about walking like Jesus did and keeping the Torah, it's somebody giving me Paul's words out of context and twisted. And he is the only author in the Bible that we are warned about. 2 Peter 3:15 through 17 tells us not to twist Paul's words and not to become lawless because he is hard to understand. Yet that is what all of modern day Christianity has done. Twisted Paul's words to justify not living a life pleasing to God, not trying to stop sinning. And you can try to play the ignorance card all you want. You can say, oh, no one ever told me. Well, I'm telling you right now if you're watching this. And quite frankly, read Hosea 4:6. The ignorance card is not going to work on Judgment Day.